My name is Aaliyah, and today I'll be talking about reducing population in the oceans. So my research question is how policies established by the UN regarding pollution intake by shipping and shipping services affect the future population intake in the oceans. So I would say that the UN policies will ultimately reduce pollution intake in the future made by ships and shipping services. So pollution in today's age is a very pressing issue, as pollution is increasing, it is affecting the health of the ocean. A big advocate to the pollution intake is the importation and exportation of products by ships. To limit or reduce the pollution intake in oceans, the UN has made an organization called IMO to make policies to reduce it. Here's a graph that shows the exports and importations and how it has increased throughout the years. It shows the world and then developing and developed and developed countries, and you can see that it has increased throughout the years. Pollution by oil. The MARPOL, which is a convention within the IMO, has introduced new concepts to ensure the majority of oil tankers are safely built and operated and constructed correctly. This consists of a new requirement for the oil tankers to be fitted in segregated ballistic tanks and to be overlaid into to carry ballistic water and cargo tanks. These operational construction regulations were introduced in 1983 and have been successful from this time. There's statistics that show from renewable industries and independent bodies showing that these regulations do that. Pollution by chemicals. There are two indexes that consist of chemicals carried in bulk in carriage and then the carriage of noxious liquid substances. In the annex of carriage of chemicals in bulk, it is covered by regulations of SOLAS in a chapter of MARPOL. These conventions both require chemical tankers built after the 1st of January 1986 to comply with the Internal Bulk Chemical or the IBC code. This code prescribes that the design and construction standard of the ships involved in the construct of the bulk liquid chemicals and identifies the equipment. Chemical tankers constructed before July 1st of 1986 should comply with the requirements of the Code of Construction Equipment. Ships carrying dangerous chemicals in bulk, or the BCH code, which is just a predecessor of the IBC, meaning that over time the BAC overtook the IBC code. In the second index, the index of carriage of noxious gases, it follows regulations of MARPOL only, and it follows a categorization system, which it contains four categories, category X, Y, and Z. Category X follows that if any liquid is discharged in the ocean presents a major hazard to marine resources and human health, it is prohibited. In category Y, it says that if any liquid is discharged in the sea that presents only a hazard to marine sources and human health, and is limited to its quality and its kind. In category C, it shows that a liquid discharged in the ocean that presents a minimum harm to marine resources and human health, it is less stringent resources on the quality and quantity of the discharge into oceans and other substances. If it doesn't show any harm, it's not subject to the requirement of the law. For the last two annexes, for pollution by sewage and garbage, for the sewage annex of MARPOL, it contains a set of regulations regarding the discharge of sewage into oceans and ships, including equipment and systems for the control of sewage discharge, the provision of port and reception facilities for sewage certification. The discharge of sewage into the sea is prohibited except when the ship is in operation and or approved of an approved of sewage treatment plant or the social supervision community in this effective sewage. For the garbage part of Annex Montreal, it seeks to eliminate any kind of garbage and reduce the amount of garbage being discharged into the ocean from ships. Under this annex, garbage includes all kinds of food, domestic and operational waste, all plastic, cargo residues, incinerator ashes, cooking oils. For my counterclaim, I will be talking about how President Trump has established his most recent ocean policy, which basically contradicts what the IMO or the UN has been trying to do. He's saying that the U.S. waters are fundamentally to the economy and security, global competitiveness and well-being of the U.S., which the UN is just trying to show, is trying to preserve the ocean. And with this all being considered, the UN enforces these policies ultimately to cause an increase in production of pollution being put into the oceans. Thank you.
I have two questions for you. Okay, first question. What evidence did you gather that you didn't use, and then why didn't you use it?
I gathered from an article that was basically saying that the UN has reduced pollution intake, but then I later realized that it wasn't a reliable source.
All right, and if you had an opportunity to do more research, what would you have done?
Just going to the website and follow the
word. All right. Thank you.